billions of years ago, Mars wasn't the dry, desolate world we see today. It was alive with rivers, lakes, and even oceans. Imagine standing on a Martian shoreline, waves lapping at the red sand as storm clouds brew overhead. But this paradise didn't last. Mars began to lose its atmosphere, slowly, silently, almost invisibly. The culprit? Mars's small size and weak magnetic field. Without protection, solar winds stripped the air away. Over millions of years, the oceans dried up, leaving behind cracked basins and ghostly riverbeds. Mars transformed from a vibrant world into a frozen wasteland. The thin atmosphere, less than 1% of Earth's pressure, cannot support liquid water or human life. Radiation bombards the surface daily, unshielded by a protective magnetic field or thick atmosphere. Today, Mars is a cosmic graveyard, a reminder of what it once was and what it could be again. But where science sees desolation, humanity sees opportunity. The question arises, can we bring Mars back to life? Terraforming Mars means recreating the ancient conditions that made it once habitable. But first, we must understand why Mars lost its atmosphere and how to stop it from happening again. The atmosphere today is almost entirely carbon dioxide, deadly to humans, but useful for creating a greenhouse effect. This is the raw material we'll need to awaken Mars from its dormancy. The challenge isn't just scientific, it's planetary in scale. And yet, humanity has always risen to challenges once thought impossible. If we succeed, Mars could once again have lakes, rivers, and maybe even seas. But to reach that dream, we must begin with the smallest steps: warming the planet, thickening the air, and protecting it. This is where the journey begins, with the dream of turning a dead world into a living one. Welcome to the story of terraforming Mars, the greatest engineering project in human history. To terraform Mars, the first step is simple in theory, but colossal in practice. Warm the planet. Mars is far colder than Earth, with average surface temperatures around minus 80 degrees Fahrenheit. If we can raise the temperature, frozen carbon dioxide at the poles will sublimate, thickening the atmosphere. One idea: build giant orbital mirrors to focus sunlight onto the Martian surface. Another, more radical idea: redirect asteroids to crash into Mars, releasing heat and gas. Each method carries risks. Mirrors may fail. Asteroids could cause unintended devastation. But humanity has another tool: greenhouse gases far stronger than carbon dioxide. By releasing these gases into the atmosphere, we could trap heat and warm Mars more quickly. Slowly, ice would melt. Water would return. The cycle of warmth and atmosphere would begin again. Every molecule of air matters. Every step brings us closer to a breathable Mars. But warming alone won't be enough. Mars needs atmospheric pressure to shield life from deadly radiation. Some scientists propose building a giant magnetic shield at Mars's L1 orbit, protecting it from solar wind. With protection in place, the atmosphere could thicken, skies could turn blue, and Mars could breathe again. Yet these changes won't happen overnight. We are speaking of centuries, even millennia, of transformation. Terraforming is not just science. It's patience, persistence, and vision across generations. Each generation would inherit the work of the last, carrying the dream forward. One day, Standing on Mars may feel like standing on Earth, but under a different sun. This is the awakening of Mars, the beginning of a second Earth. But engineering a Martian breath is only the next chapter in this journey. Next, we must learn how to create oxygen itself and build an atmosphere humans can breathe. To breathe on Mars, we need more than warmth. We need oxygen. Currently, Mars's atmosphere is 95% carbon dioxide and less than 0.2% oxygen, unbreathable for humans. But this carbon dioxide is also the key. If we can split it, we can unlock oxygen. NASA has already tested this with MOXIE, a small machine aboard the Perseverance rover. MOXIE successfully produced breathable oxygen, proving the concept works even on Mars. Scaling this up means building vast networks of oxygen factories across the planet. Meanwhile, we could engineer superplants and microbes capable of surviving Mars and producing oxygen naturally. Imagine extremophile algae thriving in Martian lakes, releasing oxygen into the sky. But oxygen alone won't make Mars habitable. We need pressure. Without pressure, even if we had oxygen, our blood would boil in the open air. One solution: release Mars's hidden gases trapped in its soil and polar ice. Another: import gases from the outer solar system, turning Mars into a greenhouse world. Over time, the air would thicken. The sky would shift from thin orange to deep blue. This would transform the climate. Rivers would flow, lakes would fill, and rain might fall again. But this is not without danger. Too much greenhouse gas could trigger a runaway effect. Balancing the atmosphere will be humanity's greatest scientific challenge. Yet, if we succeed, Mars could bloom into a living planet once more. A world where humans breathe freely under an open sky, without a spacesuit. This is the engineering of a Martian breath, the first taste of life on the red planet. Once Mars has air and warmth, the next step is to seed it with life. But not all life can survive here. We must begin with extremophiles, microbes built to endure harsh worlds. These organisms would take root in the soil, beginning the long process of reshaping the biosphere. Then, engineered plants could follow, species designed to grow in thin air and cold climates. Imagine mosses and lichens carpeting Martian rocks, slowly creating fertile soil. As oxygen levels rise, larger plants could grow, grasses, shrubs, and eventually trees. Forests could stretch across valleys, drawing carbon dioxide from the air and releasing oxygen. Birdsong might one day echo where silence has ruled for billions of years. But this ecosystem won't appear overnight. It must be built carefully, step by step. Every organism will need to be chosen, adapted, and placed with precision. One mistake could collapse the fragile balance of this new world. But with success, Mars could host self-sustaining ecosystems, growing more complex with time. Imagine lakes filled with fish, insects buzzing in the air, and animals roaming freely. This would be the rebirth of a planet, a living Mars. And yet, the ecosystem would not remain frozen in time. Evolution would take over. Over generations, plants and animals would adapt, becoming uniquely Martian.
Life on Mars would not simply copy Earth, it would evolve into something new.
From the smallest microbe to the largest tree, Mars would take on a character all its own. A once dead planet, now alive with sounds, colors, and movement. This is the vision of a living Mars, Earth's first true sister world. Terraforming Mars is not just science. It is humanity's boldest act of imagination. It asks us to transform a dead world into a living one, a task no species has ever attempted before. But should we? Do we have the right to remake another planet? Some argue Mars belongs to itself, a natural wonder, untouched by human hands. Others believe transforming Mars is humanity's destiny, our chance to give life to lifelessness. Terraforming would demand resources, cooperation, and centuries of patience. No single nation could achieve it. This must be humanity's project. Together, united. Terraforming Mars is more than survival. It is an act of creation. It is humanity becoming a force of nature itself. Children born on Mars may one day call its valleys and forests their home. For them, Mars will not be alien. It will be normal. It will be life. One day, the red planet may echo with laughter, song, and the sound of cities. A living Mars would change not just our world, but our identity as a species. We would no longer be a one-world people, but a multi-planet civilization. A species capable of shaping worlds, of spreading life where there was none. The story of Mars is not just about a planet, it is about us. It is about who we are and who we will become. And so, the red planet waits for our courage, our vision, and our resolve. This is terraforming Mars, humanity's grandest project, and perhaps its destiny.